Is this the room? Okay, good. Yeah, this is our room. Come on.
I got
lost. Join us.
Sorry.
Don't you guys worry about that. That's just the phone that the seniors prank on the freshmen. Don't worry about it.
Sure.
Yeah, here. How are you two? It's not that bad.
Okay.
Five little cronies who made a loud snore. One was shot in the head, and the other were four. Four little cronies went out to sea. A red heron swallowed one, and then there were three. Three little cronies ate a lot of stew. One choked his little self, and then there were two. Two little cronies stayed out in the sun. One got frizzled up, and then there was one. One little crony all alone, he went and shot himself.
Ladies and gentlemen, silence please. You are charged with the following sins. Ed Armstrong, on March 14th, 2008, you misdiagnosed and caused the death of Louisa Mary Cleese. Emily Brent, on November 5th, 2004, you were driving under the influence of drugs. Bill Blore, on October 10th, 2009, you cheated on the SAT. Tom Rogers, on May 20th, 2006, you got your girlfriend pregnant and left her. Don Wargrave, on June 10th, 2007, you attempted to take your life. Prisoners of the court, have you anything to say in your defense?
Well, that's enough of that. That was a little weird.
Tchaikovsky, he can compose some music.
Yeah.
Where is John?
Yeah.
I don't know, but I'll go check on him. I'll go see where he is real fast. I'll be right back.
Guys. John killed himself. He's dead. He's been struggling a lot. He's been really depressed, and he took his own life.
Guys, it was just like the poem we found on our bed. Five little crownies made a big snore. One got shot in the head. And there was four.
Oh, don't worry about what the record said. That's all just part of the prank. John was just very depressed. Just forget about it. That over there was just a prank. Let's go down to Lake Parlor and get some.
Yes. Well, it looks like we're gonna need some firewood and some charcoal here. So we're gonna have to go out and get some firewood. Alright, let's go do that.
Gotta be ready by now.
Bill!
You alright?
He's dead.
It's just like the next line in the poem. Three little counties made themselves some stew. One of them choked his little self.
And then there were two.
No. Ed was the one that went and found John. At time.
and he wasn't with us when we went looking for the wood.
He could have poisoned us too.
Now he's probably waiting somewhere to kill them, both of us.
I don't like the look of this.
No.
Oh no.
If he's dead, who is the murderer?
Sir, I just found this letter up there. I don't know what it is, but it looks kind of important.
Hold on, I'll give you a call back.
To whom should ever find my final testament, I want you to know that this message explains the mysterious happenings that occurred at Crown College Fall Preview Weekend 2009. Due to my incurable sense of justice and my fantasy of paradoxical romantic endings, I planned the murderous happenings that occurred that weekend. To begin, I told my victims how they were going to die, and in a paradoxical turn, they laughed at their own fate. I faked my own death and told Ed that it was just a joke to keep the incoming freshman interested. Seeing how I was dead, I was free to slip the cyanide into the stew. Of course, Ed knew that I wasn't dead, so I took care of that loose end and disposed of him in the lake. Once the dominoes began to fall, panic took over reason. Emily ironically killed her only friend left in order to save herself, but in the end she killed herself to deal with the pain and the guilt of killing Tom. After the sinners had met their fate, I went back to my room and I write this final confession in an effort to preserve truth for all time. I shall now commit suicide in such a way that the police will think I have been a victim and not the preserver of justice that I am. Signed, John Wargrave. What do you know?